Hi, welcome to this very small session on quantitative aptitude. In this session, I'll just discuss two questions with you. Just two questions, just that, but two very important questions. Why? Because similar questions have been coming in IBPS tests of late and various tests. I had done a session last year also on how the exam is changing. I hope you have seen that. If you have not, please watch that. I'll put the link to that session in the session description. So what has changed is that the same arithmetic questions have started coming in the form of those huge sets and fill in the blanks and whatnot. Fine, but it's the same thing. So I'm going to discuss two questions, two scary looking questions, lengthy questions, but with very, very easy solutions. Fine. So just keep that in mind. Before I move forward, I'll just want you to remind of this. These kind of questions are coming in IBPS exams of late, and you know that already. They look tough, but generally they are not. You have to think, you just have to think, and they become easy. And any new format that comes going forward in any other exam, in this exam, some other exam, it should not worry you. This is extremely important. If you know the basics of the subject, if your fundamentals are good, if your concepts are fine, if you can solve those conventional looking problems with easy approaches, elegant approaches, then no format is going to trouble you. Believe me, no format is going to trouble you. So if you tomorrow find something else, match the following kind of questions or something else, or true false kind of questions, I don't know what they can throw at you. Do not get disturbed or troubled or bamboozled, or you know, do not get confused thinking ye kya aa gaya naya. No, do not do that and you will be able to sail through it. Fine, but the concepts have to be fine. Now I'm showing you the first question here. This is the first question. It looks like a lengthy one, and this is a fill in the blank kind of a question that I think IBPS PO introduced last year in the mains exam. So we have done a few such questions. Please watch that session. The link is there in the description. Fine. Now what you have to do for me in this question is that this is almost the same data that appeared. In fact, I made it a little tougher. So what you have to do for me is that you have to pause the video here and try and attempt this question. Get me the answer. Fine. Whatever time you take, just get me the answer. Because if you look at the solution first, you'll feel arey to aasan hi hai. Isme kya hai? Aisa nahi aata hai. You'll say stuff like that. Sir, aap aasan karwa rahe ho, exam mushkil deta hai. You always say stuff like that. So don't do that. Attempt it yourself first, and then I'll tell you something about it. Please do that. Pause the video. Attempt this question. Now, how did you do this one? Kaise kiya aapne? You solved this, broke this up into components and tracked their exact thing. What did you do here? I'm sure all of you got the answer. Look at how it should have been done. It's a lengthy one. I mean, if you look at it, so you'll take some time reading it. It's that typical type that's coming these days in exams. Fine. So two vessels A and B, ratio of milk to water here. 4:3, 5:4. A is 35 liters, B is 45 liters. So this 35 liters, 4:3, and this 45 liters has 5:4. That's milk and water. Right, simple data. Something is taken out, this quantity is not known, and that's where we'll use these blanks from A and replace by an equal amount of mixed fruit juice. So juice dal dete hain, uske andar se mixture nikal ke. Simple case of removal replacement. All of you have done a lot of such questions. Same thing happens with B. Some quantity of the mixture is taken out and replaced by that same quantity of juice. Now you have got a different kind of a mixture in both A and B, which has got milk, water and juice, all three. Now 6.25 liters is taken out from A and 6.25 liters is taken out from B, and they are mixed. So a lot of steps involved here. And this final mixture, 6.25, this 12.5 liters mixture contains milk, water and juice in the ratio of 142:110:63. So that is the question, and you have to find out how many blanks satisfy this. The bad thing here is that the combinations are also there. So if you try putting in the options and do that, you'll have to check for a few permutations combinations, because options are given in this form. So this is the summary of the question, but this is where the problem ends. This is where the problem ends. Now think. I mean, if you track all this thing by, you know, doing this 35 liters and you take out 6.25 and all, it'll be very tedious. Fine, you cannot do that. Let's think only about juice. This is 63 among this. So can I say this is the part of juice would be 142 + 110 + 63? How much is that? This is 63/315, which is nothing but 1/5. So 20% of this final thing is juice. Now just have a look at the options. Just look at the options here. This is 35 liters and this is 45 liters. Initially it did not have any kind of juice, so there was no juice in A or B initially, and so whatever juice came by this replacement only. 35 liters, it's 20%. So can I see something that is close to 20% here? You look at the options and the first thing that you see is the 7 liters. 7 liters is how much of 35 liters? 20%. 9 liters is how much of 45 liters? 20%. This is going to satisfy. Do I need to look at other options? No, I do not have to. The reason is simple. You look at 14 of 35, that's more, much more. That's 40%. Fine. This is more, 60%. This is 80%. Same here. So this is 40, 60, 80 types. So how can the part of juice just remain 20% or 1 by 5 if you use any of these? No. So what is this? This is just A. What is the answer? Only A. Just that there is nothing in this question. I'm just repeating what I did here. This is 35 liters, 45 liters. This is 63 upon this total, which is 1/5. 1/5 ke liye aap yahan kya use kar sakte hain? What can you use for 1/5? 35 mein se this 7 liters is 1/5. 45 mein se this 9 liters is 1/5. This is the only possibility. This is much more. So answer becomes option 1, only A. And you don't have to do anything else in this question. So this supposedly very tough looking question, about which many people would, after coming out of the examination, all say, pata nahi kya aaya tha, itna mushkil tha, itne lambe steps the, itni calculations thi. Nahi thi yaar, nahi thi. You just could not attempt it properly, probably because of exam pressure or you were not thinking. Do not behave like a machine. Behave like human beings. Human beings are supposed to be logical, rational, thinking beings. So behave like human beings and the problems would get easier for you. Hope you had some learning. If you did it like that, I am very happy. If you did it like that only, the way I explained, it was wonderful. Look at the second one. This is your question number 2. Again, apply your brain. Think. Do not act in a hurry. Give me the answer. This is your question number 2. I will just finish the session then. Do it. So, did you find it difficult? Were the values a little tough? In fact, I made it tougher than what had appeared in the paper. Just to tell you that these values will not make a difference if your approach to this question is logical. Look at the solution now. First, let me just explain the question quickly. It is simple. A and B start a business by investing some money. A's investment is 75% of B's investment. So, this is A and that's B. You do not need to write all this. This is just for understanding. So, I'm talking about initial investment. Fine. So, if A invests 3 units, B invests 4 units. Fine. So, this is the initial investment, which is valid for a period of 5 months. Fine. After 5 months, both A and B withdraw some part of their investments. The money withdrawn by the two of them together is 3/7 of the total initial investment. What is the total initial investment? 3 + 4, that is 7 units. So they withdraw 3/7 of it. So what is left then? 4 units are left. So here the total investment would be 4 units. So this is valid. This investment now would be valid for the next 7 months, right? That's the question. So this is like that. And I can say that this is x, this is y, where x plus y would be equal to 4. You will not write all this. This is just to explain it to you, right? Now it says money withdrawn by B is this much more than the money withdrawn by A. Okay, so B withdrew some more money as compared to A. If the profit generated at the end of the year was divided between A and B in the ratio 29:34, what amount was withdrawn by B after 5 months? Fine, good question. So how do you do this? Their effective investments, if you have to write it, would be like that. This 3 into this 5 plus this x, whatever that x is, I still do not know, into 7 upon this 4 into this 5. So investment of 4 units were valid for 5 months, and this investment of y units is valid for this 7 months. And this would be equal to what ratio? This 29 upon 34. Now, that is the way to do it, and you will not take much time solving it as well, because you know that x plus y is equal to 4, or you can just substitute y as x minus 4 and solve it. You'll get the value of x and you can get the answer. But do we actually need to solve it? Just think about it again. What is this? This is 15. What is this? This is 20. It is very apparent that this difference, 20 and 15, which is 5, is same as this difference, 34, 29. What does that mean? Kab hoga aisa? Something should click to you here. When this is equal to this. When are these two equal? They are equal when x equal to y equal to 2. Solve bhi nahi karna pada. Main kuch karna hi nahi pada. So basically what does that mean? That these two values here, they are 2, 2. सॉल्व करके देख लो, सैटिस्फाई, दिस हैज़ टू सैटिस्फाई, देर इज नो अदर वे कैन हैपन. सो इट इज़ लाइक दैट. सो वॉट इज दैट मीन? वॉट वॉज द विड्रॉल? एज विड्रॉल वॉज 3 - 2, 1 unit, एंड बीज विड्रॉल वॉज 4 - 2, 2 units. नाउ यू कैन आंसर एनीथिंग. वॉट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द विड्रॉल्स ऑफ बी एन ए? इफ बी विड्रू 2 units, ए विड्रू 1 unit. सो वॉट इज द डिफरेंस? 2 - 1, दैट इज 1 unit. नाउ दिस 1 unit इज गिवन टू यू एज 5237. इट इज से, इट इज आस्किंग what amount was withdrawn by B after 5 months. So if the difference is 1 unit, then B withdrew 2 units. If the difference is this 5237, and it could have been an uglier number, it does not make a difference to me, because I try and calculate at the last stage. I use ratios and try and calculate the last stage. So if the difference is 5237, what would be the amount withdrawn by B? So that will be equal to rupees 5237 into 2, which is this option 2, rupees 10,474. At times these values can be ugly and it makes you feel that the question is tough, but the question is very, very simple. There is absolutely, absolutely nothing in this question. In fact, whatever I have written here, that is just for your understanding. Otherwise, even this much was not required. This value could have been 5237.49, and the double of that would be the answer. So that is the utility of using ratios. I'm just repeating what I said here. 75%. So this is A, this is B. So initially they invested 3 and 4. Fine. You know that this is 7. Then they are left with just 4 units of investment, total investment. So you need to know what are these two values. Fine. Look at this ratio. So this is valid for 5 months and this is valid for 7 months. 5 into 3, 15. 5 into 4, 20. You cannot not notice that this 15 and 20 have a difference of 5, which is that same difference. So you do not even need to solve the equation. So it has to be this 15 plus some value here, plus some value here, and this is equal to 29/34. So it means that this sum value has to be equal to this sum value. Means what? That this has to be barabar hoga and this is equal to 4. How can this happen? This is 2 and this is 2. So it means their withdrawals were 3 - 2, 1, 4 - 2, 2. Now this difference is, this difference between 2 and 1 is 1 unit. So if the difference is 1 unit, which is this much, how much is this 2 units, which is the amount withdrawn by B? That would be equal to double of this. So the answer would be option 2, which is 10,474. And they could have asked you absolutely anything. They could have asked you the initial investment of B, of A, whatever. It does not make a difference to us because we're using ratios and doing it extremely elegantly. So the moral of the story, we have to think. We have to think first and then act. This is important. Do not start solving questions like a robot. Look at that. Just jump on it and make all those equations and all, and then after 3 minutes say, okay, I got the answer. Probably it's very simple. Just look at that session, the one which I was talking about. Look at those 5 questions. They are beautiful, very nice, very good questions. But for somebody who's not thinking, they might appear to be very tough. Think and then act. It's extremely important. If your basics are fine, if you have done your homework right, if you are generally comfortable solving good quant questions, it should be fine. It's not going to trouble you. The second question I did appeared in a huge DI set. It looked scary, and that was the toughest question, and that is the solution. Let's look at it. I hope you found it useful. We'll just try and keep bringing to you some of these small sessions like that before your exam. It's just 10 days left now to your exam. I hope all of you are working hard. This is the time to act. This is the time to work. These 10 days, I mean, can be life changing. Fine. So make good use of it. Do not do anything new. Just, keep consolidating on your learning. Do your general awareness. That is the time to do general awareness. Do your tests. Analyze the tests. Find out what's going wrong. Even if you cannot change a lot in your basics, you can still use such things. Fine. So use such things. Use stuff like, question selection, or work on stuff like question selection and all. And it's going to make a difference. So utilize these 10 days well. Keep yourself healthy, take good care of health, and eat well, sleep well. So exercise regularly, that keeps us healthy. So do all those things and make absolutely good use of this time. Thank you very much for your patience, for listening to me. I hope you'll make good use of it. Thank you very much. Good luck.